I'm Glenda from So Many Colors. For people who are new to hand dyeing with Procion MX type dyes, one of the most confusing topics is what do I do about all of these auxiliary chemicals? What do I really need? What is optional? And how much do I need of each one? I'm going to do two videos today talking about soda ash. Besides the Procion MX type dye and water, soda ash is absolutely essential if you want your color to be permanent and not to continue to wash out of the fabric. What soda ash does is increase the pH of your dye and water solution. That allows the dye to chemically bond with the cellulose fibers, making the dye permanent. If you don't use soda ash or don't use enough of it, your dye will continue to wash out of the fabric. To show you this, I'm going to first of all test my normal tap water, add a little bit of soda ash to the water till I come up to the right pH. Then we'll try dyeing two fabrics with the same color, one with soda ash and one without. If you want to try this, what you're going to need is one of these pH test kits. You may remember this from chemistry class in high school. They're little strips of paper, and when you put them in a liquid, you can determine the approximate pH. And again, we don't have to be terribly precise with this. As long as we hit a pH of around 11, our dye will permanently bond with the fabric. I'm first going to test my plain water, plain City of Detroit water. I'm going to just dip it in, see if it changes color at all. And it doesn't seem to be changing too much from the light orange. Comparing the strip to the color-coded levels of pH that come with the strips, I'm looking at pretty close to a pH of 7. That's not going to be high enough when I dye my fabric in order to ensure a permanent bond. So I'm going to add, little by little, soda ash to this water, and we'll test it at each step. I'm going to start with 1 tablespoon, and I'm blending it into about body temperature water. Just stir it up. If you use really cold water, it's not going to dissolve very well, and it's been my experience that if you use really hot water, it's going to clump. So with 1 tablespoon mixed in, let's see how we're doing. We're getting some color change right away. And comparing this to the strip, I'm probably at about 11. The issue is, though, that I'm going to be adding the soda ash water to my dye and water solution. So I need to have a stronger mix of soda ash in the water. 11 is not going to be quite good enough because this soda ash solution will be diluted by the water in with my dye. So let's add another tablespoon, stir it up. One of the really confusing things about a lot of the instructions, both online and in dyeing books, is the differences in the amount of soda ash they suggest you add to the water. It can vary anywhere from 3 tablespoons to 9 tablespoons per gallon of water. You don't necessarily have to test your own water in this way, as long as you can approximate the right pH by using some soda ash, you'll probably be fine. But if you do a lot of dyeing, and you want to be careful about how much soda ash you need to purchase, you might want to try this little method. I'm now up to about 13 with just 2 tablespoons. I'm going to add one more. Well, actually, I'm going to add 2 more because I want to make sure that I have enough soda ash in this solution when it is diluted with the dye and water solution. One more test. And I'm now at about 14. So that's not very much soda ash for a gallon of water. It would be a waste of money to add 9 tablespoons rather than 4 tablespoons if this is going to work for me. Just as a test, let's try diluting. I'm going to take 1 cup of the soda ash water and 1 cup of plain water. Stir it around a bit. And we'll make 1 last test. And I'm at, between 13 and 14. So I should be just fine. Now, to show you the importance of soda ash, I'm going to dye 2 pieces of fabric. It's a 70% bamboo, 30% organic cotton from Wazoodle. It's a lovely soft fabric. And I have my dye pre-mixed. I'm going to need, for this amount of fabric, approximately 1 quart of liquid. So let's dump this sample out. I'm going to put 2 cups of the dye in each of my containers. Probably should have put my gloves on, because if the dye splashes, I'm going to end up with greenish hands. I'm going to rinse out the dye because I don't want to contaminate the soda ash solution. This soda ash solution can keep for months. If you have a container with a cover on it, just mix it up and you'll have it ready whenever you want to do some dyeing. However, if you add dye to the soda ash solution, it's not going to be usable for any more than 1 hour or so. So you do want to keep your dye and soda ash solution separate until you're ready to dye. Just to be sure, I'm going to use this cup and put in 2 cups of the soda ash solution. Pour that into one of my containers. Again, I'll rinse it out real quickly. And so that we have the same amount of liquid with both pieces of fabric, I'm going to add 2 cups of water to the second container. Didn't quite get 2, a little bit more. Let's take a look. I'm using, by the way, soda ash containers from a pool supply store. You can order soda ash from any of your dye suppliers. I have found it less expensive since I started dyeing large quantities to purchase soda ash in 50-pound buckets. A lot better price per unit that way. But if you're just starting out, order a small bag of soda ash along with your first order of dye. I don't have enough dye in here, so we're going to have to add a little bit more. I thought that would be enough, not quite. So we'll add some more dye. And I'm just going to add the soda ash solution right into the dye solution at this point. And we'll do another whole quart just so I'm sure that all the fabric will be saturated. Good. Now the fabric is scrunched up, so we should get some modeling. And again, I'm going to put 2 cups of dye solution and 2 cups of water. With no soda ash into the second container. Good, that looks real good. Maybe a little bit more dye than I really needed, but it'll be fine. Now, just to make sure I don't get soda ash into our test bucket, I'm going to rinse my hands off, squish that down a little bit. It should be warm enough today that I will leave these outside for several hours. Then I'll rinse them out and show you the difference in the way the dye held in the container with the soda ash and without the soda ash. See you in a bit. Here we have the results of our soda ash experiment. On the left, you can see the fabric that included the soda ash, which set the colors. We have a pale turquoise with some nice bronze highlights. And on the right, no soda ash was added. The color has started to wash out with just a few rinses, and it will continue to wash out over time. If this was a fabric that I was happy with, even though I realized I had not added the soda ash, I could salvage the remaining color by soaking the fabric in a salt and soda ash solution. This should be done as quickly as possible after you realize what the problem is. And for more information, I will post a link in the comments for this video to Paula Birch's site. She is a wonderful resource on the web with information all about hand dyeing. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to add the soda ash.